When I finish college, I want to be a teacher, and I'm studying English and French, so hopefully I'll be teaching English and French in secondary school someday.
In my experience, I've been very lucky, and I've had a lot of good teachers who I felt I could connect with.
I think some of the teachers that I had made me want to be a teacher because they saw like how much they put into their jobs and then what they get out of it as well.
When I came here, I really struggled in English and I struggled a lot. I think teachers support me in a sense that they knew I was trying harder and I needed more time than other students, and they gave me that extra time.
The teacher kind of has to walk a balancing line between getting the results and keeping all the students sane and not pushing them too hard.
Best teachers are the ones who do kind of juggle it really well, and they have like a good balance between the academic side of things and the more personal side of what's going on in the students' lives.
Someone who really sees the person as a whole and takes their interests on board and really takes an interest in their life.
I think you just have to be a good listener as well. Like, you need to be able to see behind the lines with young people sometimes.
When I think of a good teacher, it's always keeping an open mind, not shutting the door on possibilities.
It is important that a teacher does believe in us, even if we feel we are weak. Maybe find the strength in us, and that way, by exploring that strength, we end up working from our strength rather than our weakness.
I think it's really important that teachers do treat their students as young adults, especially when they're moving into the senior cycle, and the stresses and worries that they do have are things that teachers probably could relate to more.
It's that individual, you know, attention or that connection with teachers that, you know, they see you as a person, not just, you know, another student or a number. So, you know, they can have that interaction with you, which is really beneficial to any young person, you know, whether they're going through a tough time or, you know, just going through school. It can be scary enough for young people.
I think it's about being a little bit more attentive and just maybe like noticing if there's something up with some student that they're a bit off today, or it doesn't have to be anything too personal, but just saying, oh, are you okay, and like maybe a quick word or 2 minutes after class or something, just to know that there is someone looking out for you.
I think teachers do play a big role in looking after students, like mental health and happiness. A teacher sees a student 5 days a week, so they know what a normal behaviour, a normal attitude is for a student on a normal day.
You know, if you're going to spend all that time with young people, I do think you need to step up to that responsibility. It's not your job to fix it if it's a major thing, but even just having that one good person to maybe open the door.
That just makes a difference to students if they notice that, like, a teacher actually notices that they're not being themselves. Like, that does make a difference, because then a student knows that someone does actually care about them.
If you feel respected, you feel that you're, I suppose, there's trust there. And I suppose in being respected, you gain that trust.
A teacher can definitely be a one significant adult in a young person's life. A student would normally see a teacher in a role of authority and have power, and if a teacher can actually be kind and caring at the same time, like, that's so important to a student, and they can really influence that young person and help them through whatever they're going through.
I think it's that connection with children that makes good teachers, is because they want to be there. They want their young people to be happy. So I think that's what makes a really good teacher.